Hi again. Welcome back to my channel, The Brokenhearted Homesteader. Today is December 31st, 2023. Today is and has been for the past few years a very rough day for me. Personally, it is my wedding anniversary. That day, which I thought would be forever, and I thought that till death do us part meant something for both of us in the marriage, turned out to not be the case. And now New Year's Eve has been a time of trying to forget and trying to make new memories that somehow make the pain less. And the reality is that the pain isn't less. The pain is not less. And this year, the pain has not been less. So today we will, in our society, flip a page on a calendar and the world will believe that we have entered a new year, 2024. And everyone will be analyzing their year and making New Year's resolutions and trying to put their best foot forward as we flip that calendar page. So I've been spending a lot of time thinking about that tradition and out with the old and in with the new and all of those things. And to be honest, you know, 2023 has been a year that has been tough, 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 tough. If you had told me even January 1st, 2023, that I would say goodbye to the house that love built, my habitat home, which meant everything to me. And that if you had told me January 1st that January 1st, 2024 would see me here on Saturdays and Sundays and here every night, I would never have believed it. And yet here we are. So it just goes to show that, you know, we never know what tomorrow is going to be. We just can't know that. We can plan, we can dream, we can hope, we can pray, but we just don't know. There's no guarantee. So in my hours of sitting in that van and processing and thinking about, here we are again, anniversary number 14, and thinking about the fact that there's no SeaWorld fireworks that I'm going to this year. There's no big hoopla to help me forget. So instead, I decided to process and think about the things that I want to be out with the old. And here's what I came up with. The biggest thing that I want to chuck out with this year is my ability to let things bother me. That is my biggest Achilles heel. It has the potential to do the most damage in not only my life, but in everyone else's life around me. When I take things personal, when I let things affect me, that ripple spreads out immeasurably. Just in the past couple of days, I have had the opportunity where people have said things to me that I could have easily taken offense to. And I probably would have had every right to take offense to them. And in those moments, I chose to get out with the old and realize that I could choose love. In those moments, I could choose to be silent I could choose to really take the time and process what was being said and realize that none of the things that were said to me were even about me. They were directed towards me in a moment of someone else's frustration and pain, but they weren't about me. But I could have made them about me, and I could have made a situation so much worse. So that is my biggest takeaway. I have lost many things this year, my house probably being the biggest, but I have gained something that's so precious and so valuable that I will never be able to live without it, and that is perspective. The perspective of love. How easy is it for us to just take a minute in every situation and think about how we can make the situation better? Today, this morning, was hard. The thought of spending New Year's by myself was hard. The thought of my daughter being somewhere that I don't want her to be tonight is hard. But in that moment, I had a choice. I could choose to sit here in all this beauty and feel sorry for myself and feel sad, or I could choose to capitalize on this beauty and find one thing. So I got out of my van and I walked over to that lake and I saw ducks. I saw little teeny tiny purple flowers. I saw an event space way back there in the distance that I will never be able to afford to rent. But I can afford to enjoy it from my van on this side of the water. I can enjoy the music that floods across the water on occasion when they have events. It's all about perspective, right? And so out with the old perspective, out with the old needing to have a say in every single situation and needing to be right in every single situation, and in with a new perspective. The way I look at the world, the way we look at the world, makes such a huge difference in how we react to everything and everyone around us. So that, I believe, has been my gift in 2023. To learn to change my perspective. And you know what? I sat there and I felt a little sad that I would be alone. And then I got a text from my amazing kiddo, my son. Hey mom, I'm making Alfredo for dinner. You want to come over? And so I won't be spending New Year's alone. But I could have wasted all those beautiful minutes I had at this beautiful lake being sad about it. Right? But instead, I spent the day here enjoying nature and beauty and planning days that I can have lots more times where I enjoy nature and beauty. So the sun is going down, and in March I made a video as the sun went down for the last time on the house that love built. As I said goodbye to that chapter of my life, today I'm saying goodbye to the chapter of my life where I get hurt, I get offended, and I let pain win. Now, before 2024 even starts, I am choosing, I have chosen, to see beauty, to see love, to see grace in all moments of my life. Small, huge, it doesn't matter. So I am off to go have some Alfredo and see if I can stay awake long enough to see January 1st, 2024, 12:01. We'll see if I make it. But I just wanted to share that thought with you on this final day of our old year of 2023. And I will catch you again soon. As always, so much love, and I pray for peace for you all. I hope that you too will join me in thinking about a new perspective for 2024. Love you all. Take care. See you again soon. Bye for now.